Hello. A very good afternoon to one and all present here. Thank you all for finding time and visiting today's webinar. So I think we have multiple attendees here, so we can start the webinar. So my name is Neelam. I hope I'm
Hi,
audible.
Milan.
My name is Neelam and I'm representing Sargent Systems Private Limited. We are one of the leading business software solution company. We provide solution and service to pharmaceuticals, healthcare, and life science industries. So today we are gathered here for the webinar on the role of drug safety systems in establishment of global pharmacovigilance operations. So we'll discuss the scope and opportunities. So for today's webinar, we have with us Mr. Ashish Bhandarkar. He is an astute pharmacovigilance professional. He is having around 10 years of expertise in end-to-end pharmacovigilance operations from various organizations. He has joined Sargent Systems as a subject matter expert, which is dedicated for PV solutions. So before we get started, I would like to inform you that if you have any queries during the presentation, please type them into the question box in your GoToWebinar control panel. So then after the completion of the webinar, we'll take your questions and we'll discuss about that. So before starting, I request you all to put your mic on mute mode so that this will help us for listening and understanding the speaker's voice clearly. So without any further delay, I'll pass on to the this chat this call to Mr. Ashish Bhandarkar. So Ashish, over to you. You can start now.
Yes, Neelam. Thank you very much for the quick brief and very good afternoon to all of you. We welcome you all here at this webinar platform, and I hope each and every member of your family and you yourself all are safe at their places. So I hope I'm audible to all of you.
Yes, Ashish.
Thank you. So, let's move on the actual agenda of the webinar. So, basically, the main agenda of today's webinar is we are going to focus on most important aspects of our drug safety system. So, we have titled our webinar as Role of Drug Safety Systems, which are nothing but our global safety databases in the establishment of global PV operations and their scopes and opportunities. So, most importantly, part here, we will be focusing on different major aspects. It's not only about the role and the critical activities which drug safety systems they are carrying over on their shoulders, but also we will also slightly focus on the establishment, how we can establish a PV operation, what are the exact prerequisites. So these are some of our agenda points, and we will be covering all of important aspects which most of the people, I think, I hope most of the people who joined the webinar, they are from different PV operations. They handle different aspects actually. So let me just share the agenda first. So this is the agenda of today's. So first of all, today's webinar. So first of all, we will quickly go through the PV life cycle. I think everybody in here in this webinar, actually, whoever are attending, they are quite familiar with the life cycle. So we will actually try to have focus on the operational life cycle overview, how ICS are flow from one end to another end. Then the second aspect, we will be covering major departments in the global PV operations. So when we think about establishing a PV operations or establishing, you can say, at the service provider level or at MAS level, then we need to understand exactly what are the actual departments we need to have. So we will have a quick review of all those major operational components which are required for setup of these operations. Then we will quickly run through the planning of setting of PV operations. So there are multiple several important steps which are prerequisites for defining a proper PV operation. So along with that, we will also discuss few of the important aspects in planning with respect to the safety systems also. So, and further to this, the most important aspect, which are actually the core agenda of our today's webinar, is selection of efficient safety systems. So once we think that if any of service provider provider or MAS, they are planning to establish their own PV operations, how they can select a proper safety database, which parameters they have to evaluate while selecting a safety database, and how much it will be like efficient and most cost efficient for that particular company to establish a safety system at their level. And further to this, we will have a quick intro of our product also, which we call it as in-house product as PVAge, and how it will be useful and how it will be efficient. So along with the knowledge sharing sessions, we can have a quick intro of one of the safety system in industrials. So let's start with the first aspect. The first aspect is, as I just mentioned, the pharmacovigilance life cycle. So everybody, all of you are almost aware about that, how it happens, how the case input happens. There are different sections, you can say different major attributes with respect to the case processing and case flow is concerned. So we will receive the case input, ICSR inputs via various sources like safety call centers, our clinical trial investigator sites, spontaneous reports via calls, and direct patient, like you can say the HCP reported reports, literature search also. So these are some of the major case inputs via which we will be receiving the data. The case intake happens afterwards in the safety database environment, which we choose actually. Here, the most critical part will come into the picture, that our safety system should be able to process the data which we receive, the safety data, so that the output of whichever we are pulling over from the system, it should be available for your global reporting. So these are some of the major activities like triaging, data entry, then follow-up query processing, then quality review and the case closure. And along with that, simultaneously, we need to have the proper medical input and medical review. And at the end, once you close the case and go ahead for the submissions, so you'll be able to pull out different submission outputs which are applicable for global submission. So this is also one of the important parameter where the global safety database plays an important role. So as per your product approval is concerned, in different countries, different regulations come into the picture, different submission rules come into the picture. So your database should be compatible with all those rules, and it should be able to produce that important like submission outputs like R2 XMLs properly designed, R3 XMLs for EMA reporting, R2 for FDA. So there are not many other outputs like MedWatch, YOMS. Those should be available in the case output section. Further to this, once we go ahead, then once we report those cases to the concerned regulatory authorities, then we perform the aggregate output. So the data, collective data, you can say, whichever is available from the safety system, we will start analyzing that data. So in case of output analysis, as per the global regulatory requirements for FDA and EMA and other regulatory authorities like India, also DCGI and PVPI, we start preparing periodic reports like PSURs, PEDRs for US and PSURs for EMA. So periodic report compilation is one of the important aspects. After that, the signal analysis also, it's critical, very much important to analyze, to assess and to prioritize the signals whichever are coming from the safety data. And after that, we can have a proper benefit risk assessment and their risk mitigations also. So RMP is the risk management plan is also one of the parts. So these are the aspects of output analysis throughout this overall cycle. So here also, your safety database, your global safety database will play a critical role. Why? Because the data which you will be pulling from the safety systems, that has to be in predefined format. It should be globally compliant. It should be strictly defined as per GBP7 modules for PSURs and PEDRs. The predefined line listing support should be embedded into the system, like summary tabulation reports for CT summary tabulation reports, event frequency report, PSUR narrative report. There are lot many reports which are pretty much important as far as output analysis is concerned. So these are the this is the overall life cycle which we were discussing on. Moving towards the further aspect, the major departments. So I think many of you are already aware about the important departments when we try to establish any PB operations. So if we are establishing operations for overseas reporting, then in case of EU, we need to have the QPPB, or we need to have a different subject matter expert who will be leading the compliance aspects into our operations. The second important part is SEP database support. Those are system admins, basically. So when we establish our operations, so there has to be some technical IT person from our side also who will be dealing or who will be coordinating with our database providers, actually, SEP database providers. So that is also required. ICSR processing and review aspect, this is one of the department where all the resources will be placed. Medical review, aggregate reports, and labeling aspects also. The quality and SOP training management, this is the QMS part actually, PVQA. So that is also important aspect. So, and after that, signal and risk management. And the last one is regulatory submission. These are some of the major departments when we plan that we, if we want to establish any PV operations, we need to at least have these major seven departments with us actually. So moving towards further to the broader view, when we understand the broader view, when we see there are lot many aspects are there actually, if we try to establish, you can say a service providing aspect or else any pharmacovigilance, like if any MAH is there, what exactly they need to have, and as far as the service providing aspect is there, what exactly activities they can plan. So there are lot many applicabilities and lot many branches of PV where we can broader our view. You can see the ADR capture, there are multiple inputs will be received from these call centers, social media, legal and regulatory authorities, license partner, clinical trial. So we can have lot many sources, the data sources for our case processing aspect. And in case of case processing, the routine processes. So I'm just explaining you a broader view, actually, if you see the case intake part, data entry, QC, these are the core processing aspects. Report census submissions, where we go ahead with the expedited reporting for SUSA reportings, for periodic reportings, for non-CS cases also, labeling updates, periodic safety master files, and EV XEVMPD maintenance also. So submission of XEVMPD submissions, Article T7. So that is also one of the important activity. So we can have it with us, with the proper subject matter expert having people with us. So report publishing is also one of the aspect, authoring and reviewing those reports, which is important. So where the medical writing will come into, they come into the picture. The QMS, you know all the aspect, I just explained it. The auditor readiness is one of the important core activities of PVQA team. The RCA management, RCA CAPA and deviation management, it is one of the important compliance aspect. Handling the change request and regulatory compliance aspect, the quality adherence of all the safety processes which we are carrying over, it is the core responsibility of QMS. Risk management aspect is also same as I mentioned, risk RMPs, that is risk management plan, risk evaluation, risk minimization, signal detection and signal management. These are the part of this risk management aspects, and knowledge management, as I just mentioned, for EU, if we are having the establishment of global PV operations, if you are thinking of, and EU, if European reporting is there, then we have to have, it is mandatory to have a QPPB who will be dealing with all the EMA regulatory reporting aspects and their SOP and compliance aspects. SOP developments, PV trainings, safety data exchange agreement, which will come into the picture in case of licensed partners. So whenever our clients or any MH, they are having the licensed partner with them, then they can have these SDA development aspects. So literature screening is also one of those. So these are a few of the broader activities, a broader view of all the PV activities which we can plan. But how the safety database will play here a crucial role, that we're going to see also. So in those aspects, like in case of QMS aspects, how the database dependency is there, how many of the databases they have implemented a QMS section itself, that they support all the PVQA activities, they support all the important aspects with respect to RCAs and CAPA deviation. So all these aspects, the PV databases, they play a critical role actually. So moving towards, now we will get into a slightly different aspect actually, which is also, I think many people are quite amazed at how these operations are set up and how we can plan, if we are ourselves, we are planning to set up an operation, TB operation, then how we can go ahead. So these are some of the steps which I am focusing on, few of the major aspects. So first of all, we need to plan the infrastructure and IT planning. So these are some of the prerequisites like IT systems, our company website, server establishment, data backup and data recovery policies, office space planning, and business continuity planning also. So we need to actually define a proper proposal at one place, and we can go with that proposal to our clients. We can show them that we have those infrastructure and IT capabilities with us, because every client, they will always check for these capabilities that we should have it on board. Now, second is administrative finance. These are common aspects which every organization they need to have for financial planning, and the trained administrative staff is required. For recruitment of your overall departmental aspects, we need to have proper resource planning and a dedicated human resource team who will be recruiting all the drug safety associates, medical reviewers, senior drug safety associate for quality reviewers, then the submissions and reporting. So all these division-wise recruitment, these human resources, they should be trained. They should know exactly which kind of people, actually, which kind of candidates they have to recruit. So it's not only the generalized aspect. Then this is the important aspect, legal documentation and department, where this is responsible for handling your legal activities. So at the time of initiation of your SOWs or agreements, transaction agreements, the NDAs, CDAs, which is actually with respect to the confidentiality agreement of your organization or your operations. And these are some of the requests for information, requests for quotation, and requests for proposals. So these important aspects will be dealt by your legal and documentation department. So all these four aspects you must have to have on one page, on one system, so that you can go ahead and you can have the proper proposal with you, and you can go ahead for establishment of PB operation. So I am just going into this, because there is an indirect correlation with your global safety database with respect to these departments. Why? Because it will help you to define all of your processes in very cost-effective manner, so that you can have a stronger organizational setup. So there are also important aspects. So when you, I'll just take an example of service provider. So if I myself a service provider, then how a service provider, TV service provider, I can say, and I have a small team with me, and then how I can approach my clients. Like if I'm generating any lead, if I'm attending any bidding chairs means like I'm connecting with some of the clients, I'm bidding for the project, I'm bidding for the, like I'm requesting clients that please grant me the project. So there are several important aspects I have to put forth in front of them. So that is first aspect is request for information. That is they will request us, and we have to provide them how we can fulfill all of their activity specific demands. So whichever their prerequisites or requirements are there, like suppose if any client, they want to give us only case processing activity, then they will submit an RFI for that, and we will provide them the overall structure and proposal. So with respect to that RFI. Now, second aspect is RFQ, which will actually provide the information of costing behind that meeting that specific need actually. So whichever aspect, if client is requesting us, or client is saying to us that we have to do this activity for them, then what would be the exact cost? So further aspect, request for proposal, then we will submit the overall proposal, which will be consisting of all the organizational details, the legal documentations, these four aspects which I have just covered in previous slide, my overall organization structure, my team details, all the qualifications, and all the designations of my resources. So all the aspects are important, and I have to cover up in this RFPs, request for proposal. So that is very, very important, because the framework of that RFP will be also indirectly dependent on your safety database, because whenever we try to think about our safety database investment, then it will be the highest investment in establishing our PV operations. So that we need to check that how efficient we can frame a RFP with respect to the safety database costing is concerned. Now, bidding proposal, we will bid with the client. Along with us, there are different other vendors or service providers. They bid with the client. They do have different models. transaction-based models, hourly effort estimate models, different organizations, different service providers, they provide different models as far as the keys volume is concerned. So we can always bid a proposal, and after the client approves our bidding proposal, then they will go ahead with the sample cases. So they will just provide us there to check our quality aspect, that how our team is capable to process those test cases, sample cases provided by the client to us. So they can analyze or they can evaluate the capacity of our team to meet their quality requirements. Then after satisfiable performance at the sample cases, then the client will come to our organization. They will perform the vendor audit. They will check all of our quality processes, all of our control documents, the SOPs, because all the QMS aspects basically and the learning management aspects. So whenever client will come to us, we need to make sure that we should have a strong QMS policy, strong quality policies with us, a strong learning management team with us, and a strong safety database with us, with the proper regulatory compliance, and we should meet we must meet all these are some of the important aspects that we need to cover up actually. So we need to have one proper proposal with us with all the departmental information which we have along with the qualifications, rules, and what they're going to do. Everything, each and every aspect, what we are going to do, how many cases we are going to process, what would be the costing, everything would be covered under this SOW. That is nothing but our transaction agreement with the client. So basically, these are the important aspects. Now, further to the selection of the efficient safety system. Now we come on my request. Could you please mute? Because so thank you. So selection of efficient safety system. So there are multiple important evaluation parameters. So as a solution deployment, or you can say the solution provider, there are important points which we are considering. Like we have almost around 60 plus clients throughout the globe, and we are working more and more, and how exactly the client, they look forward to the safety systems, what exactly the priorities they prefer. So these are some of the aspects. Flexibility is the first aspect, is nothing but the allow your PBT departments to buy, you can say, the accommodate all the important activities, starting from your case initiation till your aggregate reporting. So all the activities should be supported flexibly with the full flexibility by the safety system. Now, the most important aspect is the safety systems. Right now, most of the companies they look for, it's nothing but a pre-validated system which will be having a fast deployment and the fast production readiness, because every PV operations, they want their safety system to get ready as early as possible, and they can start their production for their client. So that is also one of the important aspects. The cloud-based model is right now, nowadays, it's becoming more and more famous actually, because it will be the most cost-effective model for each and every service provider. Second aspect is compliance, which is one of the critical aspects actually. So when you look for a safety database, you have to look for some of the important compliance aspects. It's not only you do only cost aspects, you are going to have only R2 system with you. No, you cannot go ahead for the global submissions with the R2 enabled system only. Then you have to comply with the regulatory requirements for you to be R3 also if you want to go ahead for the global EMA submission. So these are some of the important compliance parameters with which your safety system should be adhered. That is the 21 CFR Part 11, UNX Part 11 for digital signature and all the important aspects, EU GDPR for data privacy aspects, US EPA for data privacy aspects at US, the guideline-wise adherence, the GBP module 6, 7, 9, and the pharmacovigilance plan guidelines from US FDA. So that is also one of the important aspects. If you are carrying over medical device related activities, then you have to look for EU MDR enabled database where you will be getting the dedicated medical device environment, like the product section where you can add medical device specific aspects. VRS for vaccine, global medical device reporting, as I just mentioned, the output has the medical device adverse event reporting output. For DCGI and PVPI, we have company or every operation, they should look for a proper R2 XML output, which is compliant with the WHO VG based solution, safety solution. So that is also one of the important aspects. The XML should be properly noted and it should be properly designed, which will be compatible with WHO vigilance and the SIOMs, which is required for DCGS applications. So these are some of the compliance aspects. Now the design compliance is basically your database should be both E2B, ICS E2B R2 and ICS E2B R3 compliant. The design aspect, now I think many of the people, they don't aware that it's not only about the R3 and R2 compliance, but it's about the output versions also, which we are getting. The document type definitions for R2 XMLs is it has to be, must be 2.1, and for 2.2 for the medical device aspect. R3, it has to be for HL7 compatible aspect. So these are some of the design aspects. At the technical level, your database should must have these design aspects, so that whichever output reports in case of R2 and R3 XMLs you are pulling, that has to be globally accepted and it should be calibrated with the regulatory authorities. So that is one of the important aspects when you look for a database. So what we honestly suggest, when you look for any safety system in the market for your operations, please look for a globally acclaimed system first. Now, if you are looking for a cost-effective way instead of Argus and Aries, there are not many databases in the market. Equia, they do have their own safety system. Viva Safety, Argus, Aries, Sapphire, Aware, a lot many system, ABQ. But you need to check the system which is actually globally compliant, which is delivering at least the global submission platforms. At least for last 10 years, it should be audited multiple times and by the regulators, and it should be you can say the accredited by multiple times by regulators and their inspectors. So accurate mapping with of E2B fields, it is also one of the crucial factors. Many of the databases, they have the field, but it is not mapped with their XML output. So that will create a huge, you can say, the regulatory deviations over there. So now most important aspect, it should look user friendly. So this is also one of the critical factor which will impact your users' productivity and the quality. So you should be very easy to access. Your database should be easy to navigate. Tap-to-tap navigation is one of the main challenge behind many of the databases in the market. So your database should be very easy, so that your medic or quality reviewer, when they log in and when they check the event tab, within one table only, they will be able to see all the events, all the data, outcome, start date, stop date, all the aspects should be available to them. Like some of the databases, you have to navigate between tab to tab. That is quite difficult. So these are the some important aspects, lucid and easy coding of your events, medical history, laboratory data. So this will save actually a lot of time when you actually think about the real-time environment at the ground level, at your production, then these parameters are so much important when you think about your enhanced quality, when you think about your enhanced productivity, when you want to enhance it. Really, if you're thinking seriously about it, then you should think of the flexible and user-friendly database also. Enhanced quality aspects, the database should facilitate accurate data entry. So, and the proper validations should be provided into the system, so that if the user will try to add any of the, any of the wrong value in any of the field, the system should alert the user immediately that you are adding the wrong event, or you are adding the wrong data in that particular field, and it should show, direct the user that what exactly they need to add. So that learning aspect should also come into the picture when you select a particular database. So you should have an efficient ICSR validator, and that has to be dedicated to your USFDA and EMA submission and other regional regulatory authorities. So all the validation aspects, those they will play a critical role in reducing your number of errors in the submissions, and in basically it will result into less number of deviations. So that intelligent alert system should be part of your safety database. Enhanced productivity, your database should enable the users to process the cases in more faster manner. Faster medical assessments, very easy to handle. One payscape panel they should get. Medical reviewers are playing very critical role in every case processing aspect. So their part should be made more faster, more easy to understand. The submissions also, they should be done more faster. So more and more implementation of automation should be there, like gateways and auto scheduling aspects. And ultimately at the end, if you require less time for your case processing, then ultimately it will increase your productivity. I have seen, because I myself have worked on Argus at least for more than 9 years, Argus and Iris Global, but there are certain aspects, clumsiness is there, even if the system is more compliant and globally branded, but somehow our team was able to process only 10 to 9 cases. So that is quite difficult. In compared to other service providers, they are using more cost-effective system than us. And same for the same structure of the cases, they are able to process 15 cases with the same quality and productivity, with the same compliance. That is the huge difference. So we need to see that exactly the we should understand the difference. It's not about every time it's global branding. It's not about that. We invest crores of rupees in selection of the databases. But the most important aspect is covering more and more efficiency and more productivity with proper compliance to the clients, delivering them the proper, accurate quality and productivity. That is most important. The efficient automation, as I just mentioned, for enhancing automations are basically focused, should be focused on the manual cumbersome time consuming PB activities. There are many activities like structured case intake. You need to think about automations which help you more than avoid more than to save more than 50 to 70% of resources and money. So this is a global reporting platform, which I have already explained to you. Your database should have both the capabilities to produce R2 and R3 XMLs. It should have the capability to produce SIOMs, MedWatch, and the vaccine case processing for VAERS, medical device adverse event reporting form. There are several other important regional submissions requirements are there. So you can, your database should have it. So that is also one of the important aspects. Now, the cost effectiveness aspect will come into the picture. As I just explained, the transaction-based model should be highly cost-effective when you go ahead with the database implementation, because all of your structure of the organization will be based on your database costing. So that is also one of the important aspects. Your resource planning and all the aspects are dependent on that. Technical support, it should be cost-effective. The faster deployment and the migration aspects also, it should be cost-effective. Then the automations which they are offering for avoiding your unnecessary expenditures on the resources, that has to be cost effective. So validation also is one of the important part which will cover a lot of cost actually. So data migrations, the system, there are not many models right now in the market, database to database migrations or else E2B and non-E2B migrations. Here also costing come into the picture. So that has to be more cost effective. And the system should have like every database safety team, they should have their dedicated data migration team. So that is also one of the important aspects. The aggregate reporting support and important aspect like the line listing support, which I mentioned earlier. So if you want to cover up your aggregate reporting support activities also, your safety system should have diverse line listing support, predefined listings as per PSUR and PEDR sections. If there are any automations, they should be there with respect to signal and the aggregate reporting. Audit and inspection support, it is one of the crucial and critical area where some of the databases, safety systems, they provide you outputs for audits and inspection support, the full traceability of the system, the field-specific audit trails, the case-level audit trails, and dedicated 24/7 technical team support during the audits and inspection. That is also one of the important parameter when you are thinking about thinking about the safety solution. So these are all important aspects which I covered up till now with respect to the safety solution which you have exactly. And now I'll just give a quick intro of our system which we have. We call it as PVH in-house system, which is having the core case processing, human safety database capabilities, diverse case processing aspects. So all the aspects which are there with respect to a safety system which I have explained to you just now, with respect to all the parameters, our systems also meet that. We have dedicated automations with respect to the time consuming and resource consuming processes. We have dedicated MICC solution also, which is one of the automated solution, voice recording aspects, and PB digital transformation platform also we have, which will support all of your PSUR, spreaders, and RMP, and across signal detection activities and the PB QA activities also. So this is one of the important aspects that whenever you feel that every database should have. And in the conclusion, I just wanted to mention only one more important aspect where I just wanted to mention the one more important aspect here. When you plan to have a safety system at your end, when you plan the overall structure, that which how you are going to establish your PV operations, you have to think about your safety system first at all, because that is the most costliest aspect when establishing your operations. How you're going to establish it, it should be cautiously planned. You need to check each and every parameters which I explained in the slides before, in the selection of safety system. So this is the way you should choose your safety systems and have an efficient operation at place, so that you can gain more and more client pool. Once you get new clients on board, and you actually, with the choice of proper safety database, I can say, if you deliver the client the absolute quality and productivity which they required, then your operations will become a word of mouth, and it will get a brand value also, and slowly you will get more and more clients on board, and it will increase the brand value. And specifically in case of whenever you are targeting the prospects from overseas model, then they will obviously first of all look for your global compliance, your submission compliance, efficiency, productivity, the resources which you are planning. That those are all important factors which will affect which will have a quite important impact on getting that project on board. So these are one of the aspects which I wanted to convey to you all. As a solution provider, we do have our in-house solutions, we do have our automations. So it's not like that every time you need to see the brand value. As I just explained, you need to think about it, you need to see that how it will be cost effective and how it will be useful for you, and how it will you can gain more and more business out of it. So so in this way, I just conclude my webinar, and if you have any questions, I'm very much happy to answer all of those. So you can add your questions on in chat box.
Thank you, Ashish. Thank you so much for Thank you, Ashish, for your time and for the webinar which you have brief us about. So, as we have completed with our webinar, so we are good to go for the question answers round. So I request all the attendees to type your questions into the question box. Into the question box, then we will take it one by one.
So I can see one question just came from one of the service provider. So they're mentioning how we can judge the cost effectiveness, how we can manage our activities overall, how we can plan. So as I just explained, the most important aspect here is evaluation of your safety system first. Basically, what as a service provider or as a company, when we are looking for a safety system, we usually go to many of the solution providers. We take the demonstration, we check their solution capabilities. Okay, that is fine. But first of all, you need to there is one question. I mean, setup cost and monthly cost. Okay, so it's not about monthly cost. Let me tell you, it's not monthly cost. There will be, whenever you approach to any solution provider, there will be a one-time configuration cost. There are two types of models right now in the industry. Many of the solution providers, they are following. One is your transaction-based model, which is more popular. If you have less case volume with your client, suppose 100, 200, 500 or 1,000 cases per year, or 2,000 cases per year, then you can have that model. So they will give you a one-time cost for year for that those amount of cases. So a packaged-based model will be there. So you can always opt for that. But you need to plan it more cautiously. So what I just mentioning earlier, that you need to evaluate your safety system first. You need to find out such vendor who will be more flexible to provide you the model which you want exactly. So right now in the industry, the main problem is they do have their predefined system, and whatever they have, you have to take it. So you have to pay unnecessary cost for the modules also which you are not going to use. So that is also important as far as the safety database selection is concerned. So you have to be with such flexible clients who will help you lot to actually define your package when you opt for any solution. So
so in terms of that, actually, you know, like what will be the one time cost that is for PVA, actually, you may know about that.
Yeah, for that purpose, you can always reach out to our business development team. I cannot just disclose it due to confidentiality aspects. But one of my business development team manager is also in our webinar. So they will coordinate with you. You can reach out to them. You have the mail ID sarjan@sarjan.com. You can reach out on that. You can drop in an inquiry. We can have a proper fruitful discussion. We will explain you all the models which we have. And we can have a proper solution demonstration also. And with the help of all the evaluation parameters which you want. So we can always plan that. So you can reach out to us anytime, whenever you want.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. So costing is, let me tell you, it's very cost effective. Again, the same question is coming. So as far as the global databases are concerned, so when we are planning to establish a small PV service provider base, then we cover the customers from small aspects like 100 cases till 1 lakh cases also. So it is very cost effective model. First important masses, first of all, we wanted to convey to everyone in the webinar that like the people mostly who are interested to establish their own PV operations, if they do have the clients with them, then please never go for the brand every time. It's not about brand. USFDA, EMA, they will never ask you to go for the brand. They will ask you for the compliance and they will ask you for the quality of cases which you are submitting to them. So it's up to you to invest crores in that or less.
Hello, Ashil, we have another question regarding automation used for signal detection.
Okay, so there are lot many automations in the market for signal detections who are basically based on quantitative and qualitative analysis. So many clients, they prefer many of the traditionally used statistical techniques and the data which they are pulling out from the EBITDA's line distings also for comparison aspects. So basically, the automations of signal detection, there are 2 to 3 very nice solutions in the market. Even also, we do have the solution with ourselves, a dedicated signal detection platform, which will cover up all the qualitative signal detection also and quantitative signal detection with the statistical methods like chi-square analysis and the PRR analysis also. So this is also one of the important aspects. So whenever we plan for any signal automation, we need to see how cost effective it is, how efficient it is to handle the data which is there in your safety system, and how efficient it is to handle the data from outside of the customer. So that you need to see. So this is one of the important.
So one another question is, of the so many clients, how many have been inspected by health authorities for PVH systems?
Okay. So if it with respect to our system, let me tell you, we are there in the market since last 12 plus years, and we have been audited at on-site audits and on-site inspections also more than 50 plus times. So every year, one of the major regulatory authorities, EMA, USFDA, they come for audit with our client sites, and we have to support our clients. And let me tell you, we have successfully cleared all of our major client audits like MHRA UK, EMA, USFDA, Health Canada, and TG also, and Anvisa Brazil also, Spain and regional regulatory authorities also for France also. So we have efficiently cleared without any significant findings. Many of the features of the system, that is the most important aspect which I have mentioned earlier, the audit traceability, which is the important, your database should be completely transparent. There should not be any sort of manipulation with respect to the data, safety data, which is having. We fulfill all that, all those aspects as far as audit and inspection requirements are concerned. So that is there with us, not only. And there is one question, you get automations after 10 years. No, it's not like that. Mr. Sahil Ari has added. So PV automations, let me tell you, many of the global companies, IT companies, they are focusing on automations now because that is the main era which is going to come in future. So wherever we are spending around 50 people of team for case processing in upcoming 5 to 6 years, the time is going to come that only 1 or 2 people will be able to do that. So it's not easy though. Human intervention is required for medical assessments and core case processing also. But there are already established automations in the market with respect to signal detection, with respect to structured case processing, like the cases which you are downloading from Udra Vigilance. So all those aspects are already there in the market, quality and productivity modules. So already they are there. And literature automation is one of them. And we do have those aspects with us at Sargent System. We have certain automations. We have developed major automations like structured case automation for Udra Vigilance, LAM automation, literature, submission gateway and auto scheduling also. So complete automated submission also, it is there in the market. So there are not many aspects are there. So you can always offer automations in your planning.
Yeah. So next will be from Snehal. This is, can this system integrate speech to text inputs to enable direct availability of data by avoiding transcription from MICC calls?
Okay. Okay, so it's about TV age you are saying, or else it's about all the systems you are
doing. MICC calls. Like,
okay, so let me tell you, MICC is, first of all, MICC, what it means is there are very, like, students also in the call. So I'll just tell them MICC is nothing but Made Info Call Center Operations. So all the PV call centers who will be handling your pharmacovigilance calls, like ADR reports calls. So many patients, they report events on calls or product quality complaints also they do. So so that is also important. So thing is that right now in the market, there is no such tool in the market who can transcribe the audio data into safety system. Okay. But there are automations that that have been already worked. So whichever data you will be capturing in your MedInfo system, or you can say the affiliate system, you can pull out the R2 XML output. Already we have that solution with us, which we call it as Pritter. So in that you can enter the MICC inquiry data and you can pull out the R2 XML and you can upload that R2 XML to any of the safety system in the market, and you can immediately create a case over there without having any manual intervention. So that kind of automations right now we do already have in market also. The XML automation is not there, but you can always analyze the voice recording also. So that is also one of the aspects. So there is one question by Neha Kenere, what is QPPV? Okay, basically QPPV is qualified person for pharmacovigilance activities. Whenever you are planning for European operations, like European submissions, if you have your product approvals at EMA, then you have to submit and you have to be compliant with EMA regulatory obligations for your PV systems and your PV operations. Then it is must and mandatory to have a QPPV at European level with you, your operations, if you are going ahead for the EMA operations. So this is the qualified person for pharmacovigilance who will be having at least 10 to 15 years of experience, at least 15 years, who will be having all the knowledge of regulatory compliant compliance activities with respect to the European reporting. I already explained about signal detection. So there was one question by Mr. Manish. So signal automations are already there in the market. There is one more person. Yeah. Okay. Speech to text we have answered now. Now, okay, there is one more question. So how exactly important is selection of the proper PV database, as the question is, because why I was explaining all those aspects earlier, why it is important when we plan about any activity. Suppose I have a capital amount of 50 lakhs and I'm trying to establish a PV operations. So basically I can say, I can disclose you one aspect that you, at least you should have 30 to 50 lakhs on board when you are thinking about starting your PV operations, because the safety database costing, your resource costings, your operational costings, your establishment costings will cover all of this. You have to plan it very cautiously, and you need to make sure maximum amount of money you will be investing in resources, because if you have quality resources and the safety system, you can have a proper robust PV operations at place. So that is also one of the important part. So when you plan for it, as I already explained to you, all the evaluation parameters which you look for in a safety system, you need to have a proper checklist with you, and you need to check each and every system which you are getting, for which you are getting the demonstrations. So basically, there HR systems, safety system, let me tell you one more important thing, which are available from starting from 15 to 20 lakhs, 30 to 40 lakhs, 40 to 50 lakhs. It's just an approximation. I'm just disclosing for all of your information. But it is mainly dependent on the number of cases you will be going to process from your clients. So that is important part. So according to many of the solution providers or IT providers, they will provide you this package system, which I explained, like 1,000 case package, 5,000 case package, a lot many aspects are there. So this way the operations, like you can plan your activities and you can get the client on board, you can get the database on board and you can start. This is just start. Once you establish your operations properly, then it's no looking back. Once you get maximum number of clients, then it's quite good so revenue.
Ashish, next is regarding automated literature monitoring.
Okay, Mr. Sagar, okay. So there are certain models in the industry right now which are based on the natural language processing. It is one of the important artificial intelligence technique where you can just add your literature article from the front end of the system and system will read that literature article in an automated manner and it will fetch out the data, patient specific data, event specific data, laboratory specific data, history specific data in your safety system for your assessment. Basically, you have to perform triaging anyhow there. You need to check the validity assessment, but the accuracy of these systems are questionable at certain extent. Some systems are 80% accurate, some systems are 90% accurate. So it differs a lot, basically. But there are few systems that we have also one of the important automation at literature, which we call it as LAM. We have also that system, which is mainly focused on automating all your literature surveillance activities. So basically, the data when you add your search strings in the databases like Embase and PubMed, you are pulling the line listing of all the abstracts, you are pulling the abstracts, copying them on the Word, then highlighting the event term, primary evaluation, secondary evaluation, author implication assessment. There are not many activities in LAM which are quite cumbersome, very, very cumbersome, you can say, for accessing and validating a single literature case from a literature abstract or article. It will take more than 40 to 45 minutes. So what we have done is we have automated all those aspects, and this instead of this 45 minutes, you can validate a case within 5 minutes. So that kind of automation we have focused on. We never went into that much. We have also used the technologies from artificial intelligence, and there are in the market, there are modules with artificial intelligence. But right now, technically, I can say as far as the PV automations are concerned, we cannot fully rely on these systems. As far as the reporting is concerned, because all the regulators, they scrutinize all the reports very, very cautiously. So we need to be sure that that artificial intelligence system, it should have at least 95% accuracy. So no other system is there in the market for artificial. So that's why we focused on the core processing aspect. We have 99% accurate system on board, which have been audited several times by multiple authorities, and it's been there in the market since last 7 years. And efficiently functioning. So instead of having 50 odd people in the literature surveillance team, you can have only 2 to 3 people and you can carry over your literature activities.
One another question is, can automation be done in all the case processing activities? According to one global data, there are very less percentage in review ICSR, but high percentage in submission and technology.
Okay, so there are two aspects in this question. All case processing activities cannot be covered. So right now industry is focusing on the structured case processing aspect. So likewise, I mentioned about the XML cases which you are downloading. It's a structured data. Basically, E2B data is structured data. Non-E2B data is unstructured data. That is actually your SIOMs, MedWatch, or the handwritten forms which you are getting as a source document from multiple clients. So that is your unstructured data. There is no automation in the market which is as much as successful for reading this unstructured data. But for structured data, already there are several automations. Even we do have that automation. We call it as PVD code, which will be responsible to do all the activities in an automated manner, like reading that XML data, mapping that XML data and into the database, performing the duplicate check, performing the MH non-MH check. All these activities were actually in ArcGIS and ARIES or in your safety database, you are performing manually with the resources. Everything will be done in an automated manner. But you need to make sure that in this, like in industry, there are models. They are mainly based on the structured case index. So structured data has to be there. So that is the most important aspect right now. So unstructured data, still many of the companies, even we are also working on the same. We are now very soon, we are going to introduce one new model with respect to COMS reading. So data fetch and it can be processed into the case. But let me tell you, overall case processing activity can never be automated. So don't worry about your jobs. So most important aspect, assessment part, subject intervention part, the medical judgment part, it will always be with the users, the people, the pharma graduates, the postgraduates who are working, or medics who are working efficiently in the safety systems. The accuracy will be always more in case of the people who are working instead of the system. So I have seen the trend that even if many of the major companies like Boehringer and AstraZeneca and Novartis, they are preferring the automations, but they are employing many of the good users also, candidates also, for monitoring those automations. So your jobs will never be get impacted as far as the automations are concerned. Okay, there is there are a lot many questions are coming. I'm extremely sorry. What the basic, when thinking about new systems, I already explained the basic thing when bidding proposal. Okay, Neha Kanare. Okay, a lot many questions coming from you. So bidding proposal, as I just mentioned, when you go to any particular client for establishing your operations, you have to have your proper plan, project plan, the proposal with you, with your all the organizational details in that. The documentation, the legalities will be there. Now, whenever any client will open the bidding chair means it's like you can say when we go ahead and buy any artifacts from any museum or any, you can say any platform, there has to be some bidding. So this will be sold out for 25,000. This would be sold out for 1,000 rupees. So that is there. So every case will be having its own bid. It will be like a cost will be fixed, cost will be decided for transaction based model or hourly based model. So at that time you have to bid in proper way that it should match with the client's expectations. So that is basically the bidding proposal you have to define. So when you go ahead and when you talk with client, if they're offering a case for $100 or $200 per case, then just average I'm saying. So if you are matching with them, their expectations, then they will award you the project. So, is there any other other questions?
No, I think we have covered all our questions, which
are
good. So,
yeah,
is there anything else you want to cover before wrap up?
Yeah. So, in conclusion to today's session, it was I'm first of all really thankful to all of you who shown the interest. In our webinar, who has shown how the interest to know how exactly the framework happens, how the safety data choice will be there. And there are a lot many people who are from, right now they are from college backgrounds also, and they just started their jobs also. So so they should not be worried about basically their jobs, as I just mentioned, with respect to automations. PV is a tremendously growing platform in this COVID scenario. Lot many outsourcing and the new projects are coming in India specifically for vaccine case processing. So for every new associate, getting to know the vaccine case processing is one of the important aspects. So please learn it if it is possible. For the message for the new interested people like who want to establish their own PV operations, as I explained, there are many aspects I covered with respect to the safety data, I mean database choice. They have to look forward for all those evaluation parameters. They need to think and they need to plan it cautiously. First of all, they need to look for the leads and the new clients, how they can frame their proposals, how they can bid with them, how they can acquire the project, and how they can show their PV operations in one single proposal along with their resources. So that is one of the important messages to them. So please plan it cautiously, and most important, don't go behind the brands. That is the one more important message. Many people are in that impression that if I opt for Argus, then not a single auditor will touch me. So it's not like that. I myself have faced more than 7 to 8 audits. So even I worked on Argus Energy, there were severe deviations and escalations made by EMA, even if it was Argus Energy. It's not like that. It is dependent on the processes which we are following, the QMS. Even if we are using Argus or any other system like EB Cube, RSG, I'm not referring especially. So it's not about the safety system. It's about the quality management system which you have. So that is the most important aspect when you will be facing multiple audits and inspections. So this is the message for all the service provider. And overall, industry is growing and more opportunities are coming for both the employees and employers and the PB service providers also. So let's grab those opportunities. Let's make it big, the PB hub, as India as a PB hub in future. So that's it. That's the message I just wanted to convey.
Have some one question, like, can you name some automation software that you use in PV system? So with that one question, we wrap up the session.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mohammed. So that question, I'll answer. There are a lot many automations, as I just mentioned. There is a literature automation called as Litro, which is one of the major companies. We have LAM automation with us, PVD code with us, and other automations like signal automations from companies like RX Logix. And there are other companies who are actually believing that, following the artificial intelligence model. So we can always look after those solutions as far as the automation is concerned. But what I honestly say is, please don't run behind automating overall process of pharmacovigilance, because it is never going to happen and it is never going to be compliant, let me tell you. Regulatory authorities will raise questions on many of the aspects of your processing if you automate all the aspects. Focus on only those aspects as far as the automations are concerned, where you are expending more money, more resources. So that is most integral part. So such processes like case intake, structured case intake, there are a lot of automations. Such processes like literature automations, as I just mentioned, submission automations, complete automated reporting systems are there. I have seen some of the automations that narrative mapping is also there. So narrative mapping, where you can actually draft your desired narrative, whichever you want. And once you upload any information from case to there, the system will show you the narrative output in the form which you desire. So there are a lot many aspects. So in case of names, if you want to know, there are systems. We have PVD code, that is one of the system, Pritar, then literature automation, LAM, then Lit Pro is with Aris. So Lit Pro is there. Then Oracle Empirica for signal detection. So there are lot many aspects, lot many companies who are there in, who are actually doing business in these automations. But what I honestly said, as I just mentioned, never look for automizing overall process. Look for only those processes which are more painful and more time consuming. So core case processing has to be kept protected from the automation. So the evaluation, medical review, the most important part. I have seen recently, Bayer is one of the company, they have implemented at Tata Consultancy Services automation for medical review. But I interacted with those people and I suggested them, you're gonna face serious consequences sometimes in case of audits also, because the regulators will obviously raise a question on the systems, irrespective of the doctors. So doctors are a most important part for every PV operations.
So I think now we are good to off with this webinar. So thank you so much, all the attendees, for your presence. If you have any query, you can type us at sargent@sargent.com. We'll address all your queries in that. So Ashish, thank you so much for your time, and thank you everyone. We appreciate you being here, and thanks for joining us today.
Thank you, ma'am.
We'll see you for the next time for upcoming webinars.
Yeah, and for one more update I wanted to provide. We are going to plan our next webinar on PV automations itself. So please be there. please register on our portal. We are going to soon advertise the registration link also on LinkedIn and other portals. So please register to that so you can have more information about the PB automation systems.
Yeah, and you can also follow our page on LinkedIn, that is PBH.
Yeah, so for routine, yes, for routine PV updates, regulatory updates, which will help you a lot in your case processing, just follow our link, LinkedIn page, Drug Safety with Pharmacovigilance with PVH. So you'll be able to see all those important updates. It's a knowledge hub actually. So it will be handled by myself only. So you can have all the updates with respect to your PV activities. Yeah. So thank you. Thank you very much all.
Now we are with that, we are wrapping up the webinar session. Thank you.